"Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube, and I get a lot of questions regarding scratch building. Before you go out to the hobby store and buy a lot of styrene and start scratch building, you need to practice. But you need to find a good material that's easily available, that's cheap or free, something that you can cut with a X-Acto knife, and you can make all the mistakes. Cereal boxes. Just make sure you finish the cereal first. I'm hungry." Now, when the box is open, you have a really good area to work with. For this project, I just wanted to do something real quick and simple for the video. I'm not going to get real fancy. So I went to the Model Railroader website and got one of their drawings. They always give you a way to convert it to your scale. I'm using HO scale, so that's how I printed it out. I took the paper and scotch taped it to the piece of cardboard. And I made sure that it was perfectly flat and smooth and I had a good area to work with. And then just simply cut it out. Now, to cut it out, use a sharp brand new X-Acto blade. And I use a metal ruler. The biggest advice I can give for scratch building is to take your time. Now, with one hand, you really want to get a good firm grip on your ruler and spread your fingers a little wide so that you have good control over that ruler. You don't want it kind of kicking out on you. Now, when you're using the blade, you're going to want to use multiple cuts. If you try to get it all done in one cut, that's when the blade usually slips. That's when you get your crooked lines. So don't be afraid to hold the ruler down firm with one hand and to make numerous light passes until you really start to get that groove, especially with styrene. Now, windows is always the trickiest. And I've asked people that I look up to, how do they do their windows? And they tell me that they struggle with that also. You can't risk cutting past the mark that you need for the window opening. So start at one end and then cut about halfway to three quarters of the way through. Flip it over and then start cutting from that way towards you. So there's really no chance that you're going to overshoot where you want to stop at. In all my videos regarding styrene, I always tell you to brace it with strip styrene. But for this case, what we're going to do is make corner pieces out of little sheets of cardboard. So cut out these little tiny pieces and then use your steel ruler, your straight edge, to make a nice fold, and these will help you in all your corners when gluing it together. For the glue, I just use simple Elmer's white glue. Nothing fancy, whatever you're going to get at a craft store. White glue takes a lot longer. Give yourself a minimum of like 1 hour every time you glue something. Now that I got the basic framework all done, I made a roof, making a 2-inch by 2-inch square, folded it in half using the steel ruler, and glued it all together. Like I said, this is just a quick mock-up of how it looks. Kind of ugly. But looks aside, it's going to fit our purpose. Now, why I like mock-ups is, say for example you want to do a city scene, but you're not sure if the buildings will fit on your layout. And you look at the catalog, it gives you the dimensions, and you weren't sure, mock one up using cardboard and then test fit it on your layout. Then if it fits and you like the way it looks, then you go out and buy the kit. So here's our little mock-up, our little cardboard mock-up, and all we're going to do is hit it with primer. Another thing that mock-ups are perfect for is to practice painting, especially if you're new to airbrushing. This is a great place to practice. Or maybe you want to try a different color, something unique, and you're not sure how it's going to look. Instead of ruining a nice kit, you practice on this. And so here is mine all painted. What do you think? Not too bad. Like I said, it's not going to win a beauty prize. It just gives you something to do, something to practice, get an idea of how things are going to look before you go out and build a real one. Subscribe to my channel under DJ's Trains. Ask questions at djstrains@yahoo.com and see my website and buy something at www.djstrains.com. And keep checking back for new videos. I got some good ideas. Thanks for all the good ideas. I'm going to do some more about life on the railroad, designing a perfect layout, and scratch building. Have a good one, guys.